We be here. Come on in this place, Jack, Jamarcus, and Miss Megan standing over there. It's called Your Carolina. And just remember, there are more vitamin C items in broccoli than orange juice. Just want to let you know they're saying vitamin C is good for us.
So we should have broccoli for breakfast.
You should be eating broccoli and not oranges.
There you go.
And that's not an April Fool's joke.
Let's eat it both. I love some broccoli as long as I can dip it in a little ranch dressing.
Oh, yeah.
Sure. Mm-hmm. You got to have those good leafy greens. You should be eating that anyway to keep your immune system all boosted, especially during this time. So,
How have y'all's eating habits? Are we in jeopardy of gaining the Corona 15?
I'm going to be gaining the Corona 19 for sure because it's, yeah. I mean, you order out a lot, and I've always ordered out a lot, but now you're really trying to support those businesses, so you're like ordering out for like every meal, and you don't usually make the healthiest choices when you do that. So.
Right.
I'm not eating a lot of like donuts and things that I take out of, you know, a pantry and a convenience store and things like that. I'm cautious.
What are you eating, Jack? Tell me your daily eating routine.
I've seen Jack eat, and he eats like a bird.
I have too, that's why I want to know.
Like a bird.
I picked up a few Little Debbie donut sticks and a wrapper, and I got to the car and I thought, wonder how many germs are living on that wrapper. So that sucker's still sitting in the car.
Jack.
I haven't figured out, should I open it and eat it or not?
And that's the crazy
open
part.
Like
we're worried
like
more about the germs than we are the calories right now. Obviously so.
Yeah. Again, why we're all going to be gaining the Corona 15.
Yeah. But the great thing about it is most of our beach time has been canceled, so we're just going to give the beach whatever it deserves this year.
Who was it? Was it Ayla that posted something like, well, you know, bathing suit season this year, it's canceled.
I'm really prepping for bathing suit season of next summer 2021.
I don't know, y'all. You know what I mean? Like, we're going to be outside. It's going to be hot. We're going to have the sprinklers going. I'm still going to be working it in our front yard. So that's why.
Yeah. Megan's going to be outside in her driveway being like, what's up? What's up?
You work too hard for these bathing suit bodies. You still got to find a way to show them off.
If you don't have access to a public beach in Myrtle Beach, I mean, can you go on the beach?
No.
That's one of the new ones.
People are going to get creative. If nothing that we don't know anything about South Carolinians is that they are very creative, so they're going to find some ways to do it.
By the way, alcohol sales are up 45%, in case you want to know what people are doing.
Oh,
they're on
a
liquid diet.
Uh-huh.
Think we're aware.
Well, everyone's stuck at home, so you're not having to worry about driving around, so at least
that's true.
There's
DUIs will go down.
Yes.
And, you know, traffic deaths probably will go down.
And, Jack, you said you went and got your hair cut yesterday?
No, well, about 2 days ago, yeah.
Okay.
And now my barber, I guess, has to close.
Well, a lot of guys... to my two guys I'm looking at right now, they are shaving their heads because it's like, listen, my barber, I can't go to them. I don't know what's going to happen. So the new trend for dudes is just like, let's just shave it.
I'm going to see OB, OB the barber in Spartanburg later this morning. And I'm probably going to go pretty low just because I usually get my hair cut every other week. And so 2 weeks, I don't know.
Ooh,
it's going to be cutting it close. But then I like my beard though, but I don't want to look like, you know, Duck Dynasty.
Well,
so I don't know.
You used to have dreads. Maybe it's time to bring those back.
Shave your head. I'll shave my head if you shave your head.
Well, I mean, I'm closer to it. But if you want to take a bet, I ain't never back down from a bet.
Our producer said, no way, Jack Roper. Do not.
If you want to make that bet on live TV, it'll
I get tired of being gray-headed.
All right.
Okay.
All right. You meet me on the east side of Spartanburg at, you know, around noon. It's going down, big boy.
Jack.
Okay, all right. Yeah. I caught Mary the other day. She went out to the car before I came to work the next morning, and she had the spray Lysol. She said, I'm going to spray the steering wheel and everything in the car tonight.
That's smart.
Before I get in the car.
I'm surprised she doesn't spray you down coming back into the house, being like, you've been around some people.
I get quizzed what I've touched and how often I've washed my hands.
Uh-huh.
I'm telling you, I go through the third degree every time I walk in the house.
I told you, my neighbor Lacey, if we ever see her, she does like the little Lysol twirl thing. You got to spray it and then you twirl around in it.
Well, Heather picked up my cup, not this one, but yesterday with her rubber gloves. Guess what? I didn't touch it again.
Because you do not know where Heather's rubber gloves have been. That girl.
So we come down the stairs to get ready for the show, and Heather, our crew lady, Crazy Craft lady, is wearing these bright blue rubber gloves, and she like slaps it, saying, getting ready for the show.
She pulls it out, like you're getting ready for a doctor's exam.
Yeah, she made that little popping sound.
I like kind of go like that
it's
a little bit.
Oh, no, this is going to be painless.
Jamarcus, you made a comment when I said Kate Middleton has been seen in a photograph with no wedding ring. And you said you knew that doctors didn't wear rings because this is where bacteria hides.
A lot of medical professionals don't wear.
That's what they're saying she's not wearing rings for.
Yeah.
A lot of medical professionals don't wear jewelry just because of that reason. You know, they're like scrubbing in. They're not scrubbing like a watch or a ring. That's why they
usually.
Taking
mine off right now.
I mean, that's not a scientific fact for me.
There's like you can wash the rings. There's like the stuff you can do. And a lot of my friends that are in the medical field and are married, they have either the rubber ones or they got tattoo around their finger like a ring. So since they can't,
that's serious,
not like just now because of this, but forever. Because if you're doing surgery, obviously you can't have your rings on.
So that's serious. Watches, you're probably not.
The rubber one I would do. The tattoo one, I don't know. People crazy.
It's just like a little, like,
too permanent.
That's it's too permanent too, for me.
Oh, because marriage is not permanent. Oh, goodness.
Are pawn shops open this morning? Can I
pawn
hop?
Maybe. Is that essential?
Can I get rid of all that?
I don't know.
How about a good news story? You good down there? What's happening down there?
How about a good news story? A $10,000 check was written by a guy, saw everybody in the unemployment line. He cashed the check, came back, gave everybody in the line $100 to go buy groceries.
Oh,
Australia.
Yay.
That's good
yay
stuff.
For those people. I love that.
Way to be an awesome human.
Yes.
Yes.
We want y'all to go to our Facebook page now and answer our question of the day, which, of course, is brought to you by Spinx. Have you found any new TV shows while being at home? I know the latest
Tiger
one.
King.
I was going to say, the latest one is the Netflix hit, Tiger King. If you haven't watched it, you're behind and you
I watched that in like 2 days flat. On.
It's a little crazy. So let us know. We'll read some of your responses later. And, you know, we got a good chance to check in with our radio friends, Hawk and Tom. They're on air right now. Let's see what they're up to. Well, welcome back to Your Carolina. It's time to check in with our buddies from B93.7, Hawk and Tom. What's up, guys?
Hey, Megan. How are you doing?
I mean, you know, all things considering, not too bad.
Yeah, it's going pretty well here, too. We're keeping social distancing. He's supposed to be 6 feet from me right now, but he keeps edging up on me like Joe Biden.
It's because he sees what's in that front pocket, Tom. He's trying to tell, why are you carrying around all that money?
I am ready for whenever the economy crashes and we need to have cash and not just credit cards anymore. So I got a big fat knot in my pocket.
Yeah, it's all $1 bills.
Hey, don't tell. It's like daughter's Girl Scout cookies.
$13 and some Thin Mints. I like it. That's what we need.
There's a lot of ones in here.
Yeah.
I'm rolling in money.
Roland, you're making it sprinkle, Tom, not making it rain, making it sprinkle.
Right. Coronavirus on every one of these bills, too, right?
I know, get them away from me.
Well, y'all have been kind of a breath of fresh air. We don't have to listen to y'all because, you know, you help kind of keep it light and keep us entertained. How is it doing that during such a crazy time?
Well, we're trying to keep you informed and entertained. So Tom is like COVID-19 crazy. He searches the internet. He gets all the information. I'm like, there's nothing that gets through his
gauntlet.
Yes. And so we also, though, feel like a lot of people, it's so serious that people are looking for an outlet and an escape sometimes. So we're trying to keep a good balance of things. And of course, with Torture Tuesday, stuff like that, we have to be very careful.
You know what is killing me right now, though, is this whole thing about not touching your face, because my nose itches really bad right now. I don't want you to. But I'm like, I want to scratch it so bad, but I know I'm not supposed to. And I'm constantly thinking about whether I'm touching my nose, face, ears, eyes. You know, it's crazy.
Another thing, because you got pollen, so you're like, oh, I got the sniffles, or, you know, I got a sore throat. Is that pollen, or is what's going on?
That's what we kept saying. Every time we would sneeze, I'd be like, it's pollen. I swear.
Yeah. If you do cough, everyone looks at you. They give you that glare like, oh, it's you. You're the one.
They're so judgy. Well, thank you for letting us check in. I know y'all got a show. You're on air right now. We enjoy listening to you every weekday morning.
Right now.
just tell them to watch. You're in Carolina, too. And we'll appreciate it. We'll talk to you next week, okay?
It's good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Love you guys.
Bye-bye. Love you.
See, it's a good way we can keep in touch with everybody. I like that.
Hawk and Tom always have something up their sleeve.
Always something up their sleeve. They're fun. Here's something fun to any parents that are home. Real quick, if you want to go to the City of Greenville Facebook page, they're doing a virtual Touch the Truck at 10 a.m., so right after our show, and your kids can ask firefighters questions and stuff. So that would be kind of cool. So that's
really cool.
10 on the City of Greenville Facebook page. And coming up on Your Carolina, how are us ladies making sure that our makeup is safe during this time. We've got a few tricks that's going to help sanitize all your products coming up.
Plus, helping our medical professionals. You've heard now how some of the workers are running out of their masks and other protective gear, where locals are coming together to shield our heroes from the virus. We'll take you inside their operation and tell you how you can help.
And they are still cooking in the kitchen at Wings Etc., Highway 9, Balling Springs. Yep, curbside, pick up, take out, call them, give me a credit card, go pick it up. It's good food. And they, of course, tonight are featuring online on Facebook. Trevor Hewitt will be singing online. They always have entertainment on Wednesday nights, and this is no exception. Go by and see our friends at Wings Etc., Highway 9 in Boiling Springs, and go ahead and call that order in and go pick it up.
Furnishings for your Carolina are provided by Jeff Lynch, Appliances, Electronics, Bedding, Furniture.